Hi, hunties! It's me, Fausto Fernos, with my lovely gal pal in action, Mark Felian. And we are joined here by wig stylist to the stars, Perfidia, Stephen Perfidia Kirkham.
Hi, hi,
now,
buddy.
It takes a village to dress up a drag queen, and behind many of the world's most popular drag queens is an even fiercer queen who actually styles wigs to make them look fantastic. And you've done wigs for Broadway, for lots of people all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
Who's like your most famous client? Besides, you know, like all those Broadway musicals in place. It would probably be Miss Yvonne from Pee-wee's Playhouse.
Yeah, Lynn Stewart as Miss Yvonne. Okay. That is my most recognized wig that's out there.
How does she sound like? Like, what does she talk like?
Oh, she's she's the sweetest thing.
Ooh.
Well, and you also did the wig for Strangers with Candy, second season.
Yes.
You get a little flip
Jerry
to the
Blank.
Jerry Blank's hair I'm quite famous for, because that turned out to be such a cult classic. So much fun.
And although you didn't style Lady Bunny's current look, but you've done wigs for her many years.
Yeah, not too much, but I would say I was one of the big stars in the wig stock movement. So when you see Wig Stock the movie, there's lots of my wigs in there and in Tu Wong Fu.
And you're like, what is it? You have like your hair into this pink dye job and you're just teasing stuff all over the place.
Yeah, well, when they come into the movie, when they shoot Wig Stock the movie, I have the pink hair with the fall and I'm doing the blue wig on the block. And Jackie Beat asks me, like, what that one for? And I honestly hadn't decided if I would wear it or not. I just wanted to be doing something interesting for the movie.
Yeah.
And then I ended up wearing it because it was done. It was like, okay, I'm just wearing that. It's easy.
And you looked great.
Thank you.
So one fun. Of the things on YouTube that you will not find is a good tutorial on how to make a wig or style a wig to look like a fierce, big, bouffanted drag queen.
Mm-hmm.
And two of my drag inspirations is Tura Santana from Faster Pussycat Fit Kill Kill.
Pussycat.
Pussycat.
Okay.
And Lady
She's
Bunny.
All pussycat down there.
Pussycatting. And Lady Poopa Bunny, the great drag queen. So I'm giving you a challenge is to take some wigs, ratty old wigs. These are cheap, like, you know, $30 wigs, and style them to look like Lady Bunny.
Like a million
Tura
bucks.
Santana.
Well, the secret to Lady Bunny, we all know, it's several wigs.
It's lots of drugs and cocaine.
You do not get a Lady Bunny look with one wig. In fact, I did the wig that Ivy Winters uses. She first wears it in the Pee-wee skit, the Giant Marilyn.
Uh-huh.
Then she took the tease top off of that and put it on top of a Cher wig and created the bunny wig, which she uses later in the episode, in the next episode.
So
and you made that wig for her?
Yeah, so the wig gets morphed. Like, she takes them apart. Because the top was already so teased.
Okay.
Took that and put it on top of a Cher wig, and all of a sudden she had the Lady Bunny style. But the first one you can see is the thing where she's wearing the eyeball earrings.
Sure. Okay.
So when I was watching, I'm like, wait a minute, that looks like the wig I did, but somehow she's got it long with bangs now. And she's clever because she's a genius.
So usually people come up to you, do they give you like new wigs or old wigs?
Yeah, I'll work with anything, but today we're going to work with new wigs. Generally, the first teasing and the first comb-out is the fluffiest, the biggest, the prettiest.
And you want to use like a wig dummy?
Yeah, most people ask, you know, what do you need? And I found that when you're doing intense teasing, these things just move around too darn much.
Yeah, you want to just stay in place.
Yeah, the brace is very strong, the head is strong. Mm-hmm. And then we even chose a wig that has a slight bump in it already. I'm very familiar with this wig.
Show it to the camera so people can see
having
it.
Having sold and used this wig for many years at Patricia Field, I know that it's got this built-in bump. So it immediately gives you a little lift.
Mm. Okay. Let's hold up. Can I bring it up to the camera there?
So here. Now, sometimes I put this on a broom handle and I'll just...
You just can't get that control. No. I mean, that is definitely
so this
the...
this has a lot of... this already has a kind of a shell.
If you were a novice Lady Bunny or an Elvira, you could get this and just go with that, and you'd be in good shape.
Okay.
But we're going for wig stock giant proportions.
And we paid about $40 for this wig. It's available at most costume stores.
I think that's a pretty reasonable price for this. I think you can find them online.
For a lot cheaper.
Well.
So this one was like $40, and this was $30-something, so about $70 worth.
Yeah. And so the first thing you do is you pin the wig to the block.
Let's get him his stuff here.
Yeah, I'm first using my little pins. There's the four corners of the wig. It might sound sort of basic, but I'm going to just get basic with you guys first.
Okay.
On the side of the wig is the little ear tabs. Where you, when you're putting it on, it's going to be right here. That's what I use as, like, my steering wheel for the hairdo. I'll continually go back and be like, am I balanced?
Okay.
Because there's nothing worse than
little kind of lopsided wig.
So every wig has, like, little flaps on the sides.
Yeah, the ear tab is what it's called. It's right here. And usually there's, like, a little section of hair that you want to pull forward so that later you can use it for disguising the edge of the wig. Okay. And then you pin the back, the nape down.
I'm going to get off camera and actually bring the camera closer so people can get a better look at what you guys are doing.
So here's the ratted crown, or it's already got a thing in it, and I'm going to also rat that. So I'll usually take this section here. This is for volume, but it's also, this is where you're going to connect the other wig to this one. So I took this, what I call like the soft section, so you have something to pull over your teasing. You don't want to leave your teasing right out there for people to see. So you want to save a section there. And then you take your teasing comb. This little sucker here is what you need. And I'm feeding it a little bit as I'm going along here. Pushing it down.
Rat that wig. Rat then, it.
Yeah, so since this part is not going to be seen, there's a different kind of teasing, which is just to create the rat.
And you just want volume right here. That's all you're looking to do, because otherwise, this is going to get covered, so you just want something there to hold it.
The other wig,
too. You want the side.
So there's your first ratted section.
Now, I know a lot of queens, they do this, and they're good to go.
And there was this time in the Club Kid period where the teased ratted wig was so popular, and quite often I'd start the hairdo, and the kids would say, stop, right there.
That's it.
They love smooth front and the teased back.
Let me show that there. So you're combing it towards the inside.
Yeah, this thing. So what I did first is I started the packing on the top. Then I went to the two sides because I know the wig's got to hook onto something here.
Right.
So you don't want to have all your teasing here, and then this wig is floating there.
Okay.
So then I'll do my first little hairspray section just to stabilize it a little bit.
What kind of hairspray is that?
That's Bedhead, but I usually use Aquanet. Love the Aquanet. Then you take...
Does that hold? My father's secretary, her name was Aquanet.
Aquanetta. There was a drag queen, Aquanetta. Another drag queen, ironic name I always liked, was Eileen Dover from Boston. She's brilliant. I love ironic names. So the first step is we tease the face wig. And then I usually use a rat or maybe some bubble wrap. You can use tissue paper. And you reinforce the back of that teasing, and you take a little bit of what you've done, and you hook it over.
Yeah, they sell like sponges you can get, but we didn't get a sponge today because they
were
out. Give
me from this first section, the bobby pins.
They were out at the store today of the rats, so we're going to just do this.
Yeah, and this is a perfectly acceptable way to do it.
Hold it?
No.
Okay.
You hook the hair over the ratted piece. And, so I'm going to take this teasing and just create a solid section of the rat and the teasing so there's no way it's coming apart. And, you can even take the sides here, pin it through the plastic, and pin that down. Now you're starting to see the arc shape. All right, so now we've got a nice... huge base. And again, see, I go back
to
the ear tabs.
That's going to be some big hair.
Yeah, and I go back to the ear tabs, and I'm, like, feeling for it to be straight.
Because that's where you pinned it before.
Yeah, I'm always trying to keep a straight thing going. So now then I'm going to tease around the rat a little bit more because I'm about to hook the other wig to it. So below this thing here, I'm going to tease this section out a little bit. So when I pull the other wig over, I'm going to hook it into that. And fill in this spot a little bit. But I'm leaving some extra hair, so I'm not hiding this completely. Some of this hair will be out. Yeah, now we're getting into some nice...
Now, once you rat a wig like this, is this wig kind of ruined now? Or can unrat it?
You could unrat it. You could steam it. Now, this is another thing. It's called French lacing, where you take one part of teasing and you mix it with the other part of teasing. So you're lacing it together with your teasing.
Oh, so you're trying to make like a weave of it.
Yeah, you're sort of weaving the teasing
together. Okay.
Together. That's a nice, good hunk. This particular one, I knew the set on it. It's a wavy set. So you just shake it out a little bit. And then you get up over this section. And it shouldn't fit great. It should be some resistance. So you can already start to see the bunny thing coming on.
The bunny hump.
And you want, at least for this style, you want your ear tabs of the top wig to be in line with the ear tabs. Not touching, but just in line.
On the same line, but maybe above it because this is on top.
Completely above it. Okay. I mean, it's a good...
couple inches?
Five to seven inches.
5 to 7 inches.
But I'm using the base wig as the way to keep it balanced. Keep it symmetrical. And working in a mirror is really great. If you have the mirror in front of you, it's a really great way to keep symmetry. So there I just kind of took my large pins and put them through the ear tabs just to anchor it so now I can play with the idea of what's going on. Another great way to get them mixed and solid, see right back here. Now you
back here.
See, there's the teasing, there's the bun thing. So then you want to go in and you want to make sure this wig is fully opened up to see how there was some
shape. So the nape back here is going to be underneath that.
You don't want to pull it so far that it's getting rid of your bump, but once you've got it now, see, it's over. It's hard on the black on black. You take a little bit of this teasing.
So now sometimes, like, what if this was like Lady Bunny has ones that are really
Well, I haven't teased it yet.
Okay.
But right. she would add three more. Same steps, three more wigs.
Three more wigs on top.
So you take some of that
That's
teasing.
That's got to be hot.
And you put it through the wefting. See that? It's hard, this black on black, but...
So that's going through that little net.
Yes.
And so that's going to hold it in place.
Totally.
And so then you slam a hairpin in there.
Yeah. That is a really great way to anchor the other one. Or you can also, a lot of girls, I'll do, make highlights that way. You can pull the base wig through this wig and get a highlighted look.
Wonderful. Lady Bunny, we're coming for you. We're coming for you. It's
Yeah, it's already looking good.
Oh,
so
yeah.
Now I'm taking these hairpins and putting them through the top wig into the base wig and kind of into that rat too. You heard the rat popping a little bit. So I'm trying to link it together in a way that it's just getting, I'm building more and more foundation.
So you're looking for stability, so it's going to be, so it's not when you're out there doing your drag queen moving around, it's not going to flop.
Or
off.
Even when I'm teasing it. Okay. Like if I started teasing it and this were to come apart, that'd be a pain because you want the teasing to be really joined with the
This just looks so full already.
Yeah, and then I'm going through with in the front here. And just really, again, reinforcing this line where I'm going to blend the two wigs together. I want to nail that thing down.
And so you can, like, this is black on black, but like you said, you like a nice color combination that you can do as long as it kind of meshes well together. And make sure to pull it through here so that it marries.
Yeah, or like when you see Lady Gaga's when she's got the black bangs and the white top, That's the same sort of thing.
Okay.
Or Manila, too. We'll join wigs together. Love her.
Loves her black and white. It's kind of her thing. And it's funny, when she came here and recorded a podcast, she had a black and white wig on. She's like, during the interview, the podcast recording, do I have to wear the wig? I'm like, no, you can take it off. And she takes it off, and then she's got black and white hair on underneath. It was just like,
she's so
we had
adorable.
Such a laugh over that.
I love that guy. Yeah.
You can check that out at feastoffun.com. Just search Manila Luzon, and you'll see.
All right, so now I'm really... getting a good look at what's going on here. And this needs to come forward a little bit, this top wig. So now I'm at a good place to start the teasing part. So I took the front of this wig, right? Got that. And now I'm taking the front of that wig, like about a square 6-inch chunk. And this will be the first part that I tease, which is gonna be the front.
And you're gonna tease it and kind of do that weave it together kind of thing that you did before?
Yes, a little combination of that stuff. So I'm trying to eyeball a good amount there. So what I do is get this angle coming back like this, and I'll tease in the opposite direction of, you know, like, I'll pull one way and then you're teasing the other way. So I want everything to end up over there. So you take your two sections and you tease and you flick. So I'm catching hair with the comb, and then I'm letting some be free. So you don't end up like that previous thing that was just a mm-hmm. ball.
Right.
This is now controlled because you are pushing the hair over the top. See, that's a great section right there. You're pushing it over the top, and you're creating the front of the wig. And I'm fanning across as I go across. And I'm feeding with my fingers here, too. It's all happening at once.
Okay.
I'm feeding. I'm looking for where it needs to be blended. See what I'm in? It should not come apart.
And so...
So I just put a pin in it.
Keep it together. Keep the two wigs together.
Yeah, it's really important. And even at this point, because this is going to be underneath, I can do a little bit of this action where you lift that section up and give it just a little more.
Because you're looking for volume underneath.
We're trying to get as close to a lady bunny.
We want this hair
size.
To be as big as this hair right here.
Oh, this is going to be way bigger than my hair today for sure.
It's gonna, you guys can go out on a date together, Elvis and
Smellvira.
Now, how long will this take you, approximately, from start to finish?
It's about this kind of style is about a 20-minute story. Mm-hmm. Just the physically teasing it. It takes time and practice to get it just right. See, now I'm going across the front, and I'm not pushing down on it quite as much. I'm trying to keep a lot of soft hair, and you can see now.
To lay it. It seems like you're trying to lay it a little bit, right?
Yeah, I'm not pushing it down on itself as much. I'm really pushing it back. And I'm really trying to make sure that I'm catching that front wig and smashing that in. So there's that area right there. I know where the two wigs are meeting.
Mm-hmm.
So you can see I'm really getting in there intensely so that that will become a non-issue, the two parts.
So they're going to be just meshed together.
So fused together that there's no way to get them apart other than, you know, rake them. So there we go.
That's why it's called a weave, huh?
See, look at that now. There you got the front of your wig.
That's a good 6 inches.
Yeah, that's what he said. All right, so you can see, like, it's beginning there, but that's not even all of it. So you go behind that, you want to do a little support spray.
Can you ever use too much hairspray?
Yes, especially something like stiff stuff or something that is so freezing spray. While you're teasing it, you need some movement.
Okay.
Once you've got it finished, you can freezing spray it, but those sometimes make the wigs look kind of gray, cloudy.
Okay.
But I love good old Aquanet. I mean, that stuff works great for me. So now I'm going to my next section on this wig where I've left a little bit of soft hair here from the ear tab. And I'm going to push, since I want this section to be a big side, I'm going to push it this way and then bring it back. So that's kind of the
forward
technique.
And then back.
Opposite, yeah, you're pushing it one way to bring it back with some resistance.
Okay.
Because right now there's no resistance. It just goes right down.
Mm-hmm.
Which this would be a great place to do a friend's twist. Like if I were doing a friend's twist, leave that, close here, you're done. But since we're going for a full all across look. So now where I kind of, in my mind, I start in that corner where this is ended and I start slamming it into that corner. And then I'm working my way across the top as well. But that corner there is my little focus point.
I feel like I want to hold this for you.
It's all right. I'm used to it. It's normal that it moves to some degree. But if you were, like you said, doing it with a foam head and a broom, you could not get this.
What do you recommend for somebody? Have somebody hold it for you?
No, you can
glue it down.
No, you got to get the wig stand.
You got to get the wig stand.
Treat yourself to a wig stand. Those old blocks from beauty school are great. You know, the ones that you can find at thrift stores.
Okay.
With the hair cut off, those are perfectly fine. And, you know, you can go to the internet and get these wig blocks, which they're great to have.
Because a lot of the working drag queens, the big names, they don't do their own wigs. They typically have somebody else do
it. Yeah, it's kind of a mixture.
It's a specialty, really.
Yeah, not a lot of girls doing crazy styles, but most people have, like, learned how to travel with their mm-hmm. drag. So even somebody like Manila or Mimi, even though they're not doing these teased hairdos, they learned how to stack things in a way mm-hmm. that you get that effect. Yeah, I mean, stacking is a big part. So I've worked my way from that point in the front. Now I'm all the way to the side here. You see how it takes, there's an effort of time there, like, but I can see this is going to be good.
Mm-hmm.
'Cause look at that when you start to pull it back.
So there's some volume there.
Yeah, and you're just going to lace that into the front too. So this is looking really good. Like at one point, I shouldn't be able to see over it. Like when I get to this point here.
Oh, really? Like, hello?
Hello, under there.
Oh, this is well, man, it's like this giant shag. It's like Cousin Ed at this point.
Yeah, and see, I treat wigs like Legos in some regard. I know how to take basic pieces and put them together and get what, you know, from A to B. That's something, yeah, that having the wig bars.
Now with the stacking, if I wanted this higher, so I would have already done this, and then I would have put another wig on top of this, and with another, and then another, and then another, and then the sky's the limit.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of time what Lady Bunny will do, and some people will do, is they'll have the base wig, and they'll pin one wig on going this way and one wig on going that way. So you get that double volume.
Yes.
But then you gotta blend the center area to some degree. Okay. I mean, Bunny right now, I think at this point, she's wearing five wigs. I saw her not too long ago performing at Pat's party. And she had, the base wig was a shag, and then she had four other shags pinned to it. It was extraordinary, but it looked like it was killing her.
All right. I could imagine that'd be very heavy and hot.
Well, yeah, you know,
Let me ask you a piece of advice on that. It's like, I always find wigs to be very hot to wear. Is there any way to keep it cool? Can I put an ice pack in there?
No, there's no cheating in that regard. So now I've worked my way around to the back. I'm getting to, like, the crown or, you know, the top of your head. So this is where there's extreme teasing and stuff. See, this is the part where we should disappear soon.
We're hiding. We're in the bushes.
And it, for me too, there's always this constant fanning it out. Fanning it all out.
And it's just, you're holding onto some of the hair and you're just...
And I'm feeding a little bit. I'm picking like which sections to let go and which sections to flick away. Yeah, teasing is... It's an art form that I had great teachers with, but it... It's true. You don't find
your drag inspiration is like the years of the beehive generation.
Yes.
The 60s and when teasing was all the rage.
Yeah. I mean, this to me is very much like Divine's hairdo, but it also is Priscilla Presley, those things. It's that. So now you can see that side's completely teased out and this side's just waiting for some love.
Let's turn that around to the camera so we can see it.
So see, there's... the big dent of what's not been done.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a very good sign because look at how the volume that we've got there. Now we're going to get the same thing on that side.
Oh, wow. It's going to be amazing.
Exciting. So again, I worked my way from the bangs and the top up, then the corner to the side out. Then I fanned across the back and doing the crown. And I went about halfway down the length of the hair. And now I'm going to start in this corner again, and then I'll go back and tease the whole back as well.
Okay, so you'll tease all the way to the bottom?
To about the mid-range, because there's a different teasing for hair that is going to be down.
Okay.
It's not quite as hard.
And what did we say about the hair at the ears?
Well, the ear tab hair, I generally will leave a section down so that you have somewhere to go.
Okay.
If you've teased every inch of the wig... Sometimes you want to hide, or you want to disguise stuff, or you just want to have some areas that's not teased, that's soft.
So it's a little more silky look.
Yeah, so I generally leave this ear tab part out and decide later.
What you're going to do with that.
Yeah, okay. and then I see exactly where the fringe, the bang is coming from. So that's a section. Now I'm going to take this again.
From the ear.
Yeah, and I take the base wig and the top wig, and I'm going to slam it into that corner again, right here from the other direction.
I feel like I'm a believer now, like I'm going to be a hair hopper.
Oh my God, this is so hair hopper. So it's like, there is this pattern. It's like pack, pack, flick, pack, pack, pack flick. Flick. Yeah. I never really noticed it before, and someone that was filming me before said, there's this pack, pack, flick going on. And for this style, that it is.
Pack, pack, flick.
You know, there I did like a triple pack. And then here's like a pack, pack, flick, a triple pack on the side, like... And
you do it because you feel it.
Yeah.
You're so in tune with the hair, you're like, pack, pack, flick, pack, 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 flick.
Where do I want this volume to end up? Okay. Yeah, and like, The sides have got to be sturdy on this.
Mm-hmm.
And,
Because we gotta look good, girl.
Bitch has got to look good, honey.
Oh, Perfidia is amazing. I'm just like...
See, this part... I start to get a little tired. I need a sarsaparilla. but it is kind of like, It's funny, when I get on a mission to tease mm-hmm. something out, I will sometimes work through the pain just to get to the other end. Because you have to have, in some degree, you have to have a big mess before you come back and you have the beautiful something underneath. All right, so now I'm coming into the home stretch.
So
now.
This is the back.
Yes. So here's the home stretch. We've got our two sides built up.
Mm-hmm.
Pack those together. And we're getting most of our height from
so
this.
So you're making
too.
This kind of one thing, really.
Yes,
one ball
it's big,
this thing.
Fanned
so it's
out.
Like...
Big fanned out, crazy mess. And then that helps me, once I fanned it out, then I can see where I'm at.
Now, we've lost some hair on the ground. I don't know if you can see
that's
that.
That's normal.
Can we just glue that back in, or is it
no.
just, it's just, it's gone?
Don't bother. you've got better things to do.
Okay.
So, now I can see
that for my merkin.
Yeah, there you go. I can see the fan of what I did, and then I'm going to take a really big section and start. So I'm not teasing the whole thing together, even though I'm holding the whole section. I'm starting at the corner,
mm-hmm.
and I'm flicking it forward, and I'm feeding. So I'm not ending up with one big ball. That's one of the things, unfortunately, that some people get when they're teasing. Before you know a lot about direction, people tend to pack straight down, and then they don't know where to go from there.
And so you need to flick it in one way, and you need to flick it the other way.
Think about where you want
it
to end up, and then...
And then you're trying to make it, like, all over.
Yeah, okay. Like, you're creating the resistance is what the teasing okay. is. You want it to be fanned out in a way that when you bring it back the other direction, there's something to fight against. We're really close now.
We're coming to it.
Stay liquid eyeliner.
Liquid eyeliner.
And then this down here, we call this the kitchen.
Why do you call it the kitchen?
It's just it's drag slang, and it means, and it's also in black hairdressing. It just means the back of your head, or the back of your wig, or the back of your weave.
The kitchen.
Down here in the kitchen, and then your hair can get nappy in the kitchen, so you need to get a little perm fresh.
Oh.
All right, so now we're really
holy at a good thing is like it's Cousin Ed.
Hey, we're at a good spot, so I'm now encouraging all this air that's in there to be in it. But you see how I didn't destroy the curl at the end? That's a big part of what I do, too. When you pack only and there's no flick, this goes away. Because you can kind of see, look, there's a lot going on there.
Pack, flick, pack, flick.
Yeah, if you
pack,
just
pack,
have a
flick.
Ball of teased hair, there's nowhere
yes.
to go. So it really is about where am I going to go from here?
Ooh. I keep thinking it's going to fall off. It's so beautiful.
See, and then I do, this is another technique, the sort of flick and fan out technique, where now I'm just getting a general idea.
Because you don't need to comb it, you just need to kind of...
Well, I'll brush the surface once I figure out where, what I want.
Oh my God.
See? Mary Louise Gertrude.
Wow.
So then you take that soft hair that I left in the beginning, that's your sweet soft hair that is now able to be zhuzhed, and you don't have to expose the teasing as much.
Zhuzhed is French for zhuzhe.
Zhuzhed,
you zhuzh it.
Yeah, see that's looking great.
Wow.
So I'm encouraging this all to be up and fun and fanned out. Then you come on the sides here. See, now I switch to the other side of my comb.
Your
now
pick.
I did all the brutal. Now it's all about the pick. And you go through with your pick, and you try to get something pretty out of the mess without disturbing the underneath. So see how I'm holding it up? Mm-hmm. Instead of going like this and pulling all the teasing out, I'm holding the teasing up so it can
kind of
survive. Yeah, so it can survive the picking. Because that happens, too, I think, with a lot of people. They'll do the teasing, and then when they're styling it, it all goes away. So you take that, and then you can lift, that kind of thing. Or you can also take the brush and just kind of smooth the surface. You can also use like lanolin or wig oil spray to do this part to detangle to some degree.
Because what you're trying to get is you're trying to get a nice smooth effect, not the rattiness.
Yeah, for this. Mm-hmm. Sometimes ratty exposed is great. But with this one, I'm kind of thinking a slightly smoother. But she's still some trashiness.
Oh, yeah. Well, the person that's going to wear it's real trash.
And then we got this accessory, which in my mind I envisioned it would be like right about here. Mm-hmm. So we'll put that in there so that we can dress around it. It's starting to look very Jackie Beat to me.
Jackie does love to do those little things in her hair, doesn't she?
And she's one of the queens of big hair. I don't know who does her hair, but they do a great job. Mm-hmm. I love me some Jackie Beat.
You can't say bad things about Jackie now, because now that she's got her hip replacement, she's going to be able to run after you and beat you up.
Oh, I love her. I think that she's one of the most clever writers
in the scene.
So now I've got this special effect there, so I want to do this thing where it's sort of exploding out of the thing, out of the lock. What am I talking about? The bracelet there. Mm-hmm. So I'm sort of fanning it out.
The diadem.
To be featured like around that. And then look for pieces that, you know, are softer and bring those down.
So you're bringing that down.
So it's enormous.
Oh my gosh. And so, wow. In the back, since nobody will see it, you just leave it ratty.
You could. You certainly could. Because there's definitely something to be said for that kind of a look.
Well, you could also do the same what you're doing here.
All over. Back. Yes, sure.
And just kind of lay it right.
Mm-hmm.
Well, it looks like I know somebody who's going to have to get into drag to try this thing out. Now it's even getting even bigger.
Yeah, see, now I'm going behind the smooth area and getting some of the volume back from when I just pulled it out and put that headband on. We lost a little bit of our stuff. So now I'm putting it back in there.
I gotta come on this side to look at it real quick.
It's crazy. As in good. And
that is... It's like a giant hairy spider.
So... This wig, we had talked about sort of Turisatana, or that always translates to like a Betty Page kind of thing to me.
Mm-hmm.
So I quite often will custom cut the wigs, the bangs of my styles, just to give them a slightly different thing. Like you couldn't buy a Betty Page wig off the shelf very often. So it's a rounded bang. And a lot of times on the wigs too, I don't cut a straight line, at least not at first.
Because you want to see how it looks.
Yeah, like. And like you might get more weirdness and then like go back in and just get rid of the weird stuff. And then you can zhuzh it in. I mean, look at that. It's like looks like it's straight.
Mm-hmm.
Now let's see. So with the back of this one, what I would do for this style is just smooth out some sections, but not all of it. And just kind of, sometimes I'll wrap it around my finger. I like to do this curl where it's like a loop like that.
Oh.
So you pull the hair out, and instead of doing a round barrel curl that's closed, you put your finger in the high part, and see, you get lots of volume that way.
Oh my
God. So it's almost like you're getting a double barrel curl.
Let me see, you can do what?
You put your finger in here, and it's creating like an S in the hair.
And then you're going to spray that into place.
Yeah. See, now you're getting like, it's still fuzzy and fun, but it's getting
goddessy now.
A formula, yeah. And see, then when I take this part, I was going to do it forward, but the wig is sort of telling me to some degree what it wants to do. So,
you're like a wig whisperer.
I am completely a wig whisperer.
You listen, the wig will tell you the wig what tells it wants you, from you.
Yeah, and vice versa. It's totally true. So there you can see I'm starting to get like a do other than just a mess. And then since this base wig is more like a share, I'm just going to accentuate that. And
wig,
just,
we're going to break you down, and then we're going to build you up.
Yeah, and then like I'm starting to bring this in to create a this kind of this wave. It's like almost an exaggeration of the 80s wave, you know, the side panel.
Mm-hmm.
And this is where these pins come in so handy. Love these things.
Those
you can
are big
literally
pins.
Lay it in the hair.
What are you doing over there?
I'm laying it in the hair, and it's creating a wave for me. See, there's that blonde one there is bugging me. But see, it's so hard with the black on black. But see what I mean? Like,
mm-hmm.
just lay them there while I'm styling the rest, and it'll hold that part in.
So it's a temporary thing.
Yeah.
Yeah, or like I might decide just to tuck them in and leave them there forever, but
because you don't really see them in the blind.
And you generally you want the bangs to be the furthest part out. You don't want your side to
right.
be further than your face.
You want to show your pretty face.
Yeah, and look at this profile we're starting to get. It's very Wonder Woman, you know, like the bang and then the bump and. So here I'm gonna keep doing this petals.
Petals.
So I'm laying it on top of the teasing without getting in there and disturbing it too much.
I'm still trying to, I mean, with your fingers, I'm gonna have to go back and look at that some more. Cause it's just,
yeah, bring it out.
Bring it out.
And I'm looking for the wave that's in there already. See, there's the bottom of it.
Find the wave.
I flipped, see, I inverted that. And then it's like this action. Let me see. Now that you're looking at me, I can't do it. It's this.
And you're just like, I will put you in place and you will stay.
And like, these look great deconstructed. So, you know, that falling out is still lots mm-hmm. of fun. But if you wanted something like that not to fall, you could pin and place it, which I'll do one of those here.
And it's giving great volume and style.
Yeah, look at it. I mean, it looks like you're getting, for each loop, you're getting double the barrel curl space
mm-hmm.
as to if you were to roll it down in a traditional barrel curl, which is you wrap it around your finger and you bring it down like that and you place it.
Mm.
That's how I do the big barrel curl stuff. But since this is more of a wafty down do, I'm sort of going with these things. But it's starting to get a little long for them to hold. Mm-hmm. So just let them do what they want to do. Yeah.
Again,
just,
listen to your wig. Your wig
yeah.
will tell you what it needs.
Play with the surface. Soften up the surface. And, yeah, because this one we kind of had decided she's not a clean girl. She's kind of trashy. And this will be a mountain of hair. Because I can feel it already. It's really in that crazy good proportion. And then it start on the other side and do my little petal thing. So it's like this. You're holding your finger in there and you're bringing that one down.
It's a goddess now.
It is very, it's getting kind of almost like 70s Grecian.
Mm-hmm.
Charlie's Angels, all that stuff too, is a huge, huge inspiration.
What's your first wigs look like when you first made them?
I didn't know what I was doing, and I would say that they were just kind of, trying to style with only Low-gry. Hairspray, trying to style with only hairspray.
Oh, really?
So okay. I would put the hair where I wanted it and spray the hell out of it, but you couldn't get it really. It wasn't until the art of teasing came into my life that I realized how to get what I want. Well, there's also this movie, which I'm sure you guys probably have heard of by now, The Queen.
The Queen.
And that's where they took those samples of, you know, she doesn't look beautiful tonight. There's a lot of these drag singles.
Okay. Yeah. All right.
It's from a movie that my drag mother was in, International Crisis, called The Queen from 1968.
And that's where they filmed the New York Queen's...
The ball.
There was a ball. There was a
yes,
pageant.
Yes.
Okay.
And the MC, Jack Doris Show, is a legendary drag mother in New York
mm-hmm.
and was Crisis's drag mother. She's my drag grandmother. So the lineage of drag is really, really good in New York, the way it's connected. And that movie, like Wigstock, it gets this renaissance every couple years. New people discover it. And the last batch was of the computer ilk, like we're talking mm-hmm. about, that took that song and sampled the shit out of
right.
it. But
those things sound familiar. Unfortunately,
it's the famous scene at the end.
Seen the
Crystal LaBeija,
okay,
the mother of the House of LaBeija, is reading The Queen Who Won and saying the contest is fixed, and it's about the funniest 15 minutes you have ever seen. And she uses slang that is used today.
Oh, yeah.
Miss thing, stuff like that.
Oh, yeah. And the finger snap.
Yeah.
I was just watching something on YouTube the other day called The Story of Jason, and one of the cops comes up to all these queens on the corner like, why do you do that finger snap? And the queen was like, I will never tell.
Exactly.
You're like, all right.
So now I've worked my way to the other side here. I'm going to do the same.
So you're going
to
make that little wave. You're going to pin those in.
Yeah, this is part of her look.
Mm-hmm.
You see. Each girl's got some.
Pulling it back to expose the pretty, pretty face. Mm-hmm. Or not so pretty face in some people's case.
And,
watch it.
Just some little fun details like that. Now I've got this last corner to do. So I'm just trying to find what's soft in the craziness.
Mm-hmm.
And just bring that to the front a little bit. But since it is so crazy, that's going to be fine with this. I mean, it's just a mountain. Love it. So that's another trick there, just wrap it around your finger. So that's a good sign if you cannot see me from the other side of the wig. So here I'm just taking these longer bits and just combing them out a little bit and just wrapping around my finger. That's why I picked that wig.
Because it has natural curls.
Yeah,
to
if
it.
You're natural, ha, that's hilarious.
Well,
but curl, yes.
Curl.
If you Built pick in. Wigs that have got some story to them already, then the story that you end up with is going to be more interesting. If you take a bone straight wig and do this, you're not going to get the same effect because you need.
Now, what if I wanted to make
bend.
This longer? Would
you
I...
could add wefting to it for
okay.
sure. You could totally add wefting to it. Now, wow, we have got. A big, big, delicious, pageant-ready hairdo.
Wow. Miss Continental, super-sized wig.
Yeah, this is definitely in the wig stock flavor. I'm loving her.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to add a little flourish of...
Some rhinestone-y?
Yeah, bobby pin action as decoration. I like that.
So how long do you need to let this cure before you put it on somebody's head?
We're going
to
put it on you in a second.
No, I think Saltina's going to wear this.
Okay, let's see. So I often quite like to put them on myself just to see where I've gone with them.
Mm-hmm.
It's not uncommon. Today I couldn't, but I totally try them on. One of my biggest customers right now is All Beef Patty from Lips. She was on
All Beef Patty.
She was on America's Got Talented.
Okay.
This Got Talented. America's Got Talent
uh-huh.
this season, or maybe it was last season.
Uh-huh.
All right. So now, do you want it longer, or do you mind if I trim it? I think it needs a little trimmage.
Go for it.
Yeah.
Make it. What
do
you
it.
Think.
What you think.
Yeah, because this straight isn't exactly as interesting as I think a little bit shorter is on this wig.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just taking off just the bottom here.
You want that full. You don't want the looking like it's straggly in the bottom.
Yeah, I mean, that can work too, but just it's kind of evolving into this thing that's wide, and the long hair doesn't give you the width quite as much. And now at the very, very bottom here, we're just going to clean up the last little bit here and sort of even out whatever was caught in the teasing from when I just trimmed it.
There's a rat in there. Get it out.
No. Get that rat out. So there is just a little more that didn't get in my haircut that was in the teasing.
I'm just amazed in the short amount of time that you're able to take two wigs and be able to do this. It's just.
And then you were also asking me about the hairnet too. Mm-hmm. Why the hairnet? And I'll show you why the hairnet. The hairnet has this, I think, this great way of compacting the story that I've been just telling. You kind of put it over like that.
So you're putting the hairnet on there? Is that for it to stay?
No, just for styling.
Okay.
See? And then I go in there and I kind of kick out all the dents that are not like the others. See?
Ah.
It's a great way to get...
So it kind of holds it in place where you're able to, like, move it where you need
move
to
it,
be.
Yeah. See? And even just that little bit of that, look what that did.
Yes. I see.
But especially if I were doing a big French twist, those are great under a hairnet. So, all right, are we ready to see it?
I think so.
You gonna come over?
I saw Tina ready for her
I'm
debut.
Ready. Let's put it on.
Let's put it on.
It'll stop packs, keep docking, but.
Okay.
That and then when it's like, on you too, I'll have a little more idea what I want
what
to trim.
What you should do and how it should look and what to do with it.
But I think it's going to be
hysterical.
It looks.
That is a wall of hair.
That's Lady Bonnie right there.
Still would be small for her.
Yes.
You know what? Lady Bonnie.
Hi, is my wig ready?
Here we go. You ready?
I'm ready.
I'm going to hook around the side there. Oh, it's always bigger than I thought it was, which is a good thing.
Oh. Hold on, I'll hold you up.
I don't think my neck can handle it. It's so big. Ooh, it's so big.
And juicy. That is good stuff.
Put this together.
I'm ready.
And I love this little trick, the bobby pin at the hairline trick. It's kind of a throwback to the Club Kid era.
What little trick is that?
This feels very secure.
Just to hold it in,
Perfidia.
And it kind of is great around the Betty Page bangs. It just kind of pulls it in.
Makes
and if there's
tight.
An interesting bobby pin or interesting jewel or something, yeah. It's a great spot.
Hide your sideburns, honey. Hide your sideburns.
How do you hide the side? What's the best strategy for sideburns?
A little eyelash glue and just glue it from the ear tab down, right down onto you.
We've learned so much about dressing up in drag from Perfidia.
Yeah, the eyelash glue is a trick
do
I always
twirl.
Use.
Are you ready for a twirl yet?
Oh my god, it's enormous.
This is my little lady bunny.
It is funny.
How does Clay Aiken remove
it? How does Clay Aiken remove a condom? He farts it out.
Oh my god, that's funny.
Perfidia, you are a wig stylist extraordinaire. Probably one of the most virtuoso. You're a wig master. Yes, make your head big. As big as your hair.
That's the title, isn't it? Wig master? Or is that...
I'll take it.
In the theater?
Sure.
All right.
So that is it. You can listen to our podcast where you can hear all about Perfidia's amazing life and adventures with drag queens, supermodels, actors, and even Peruvian princess Ima Sumac. Which we remember the song Malambo Number 1, which Jinx, Monsoon, and Detox had to lip sync for their life on RuPaul's Drag Race.
For their life.
One of them got to live.
Yes.
Bring me my girls.
How are we gonna store this?
Well, you need a head. You got a head, but this needs a little...
You have to wear it all the time now.
Yeah.
All right. How do I take a shower with it on?
Ask Bunny.
So put it on the head. Do I have to put it like anything over it so it doesn't get dusty? Or is
yeah, you can put it. You can put a garbage bag over it or a plastic bag. Sure.
When Lady Bunny travels or drag queens travel with this wig, what do you recommend they do with it to go to a gig?
A lot of girls have a wig suitcase or carry on's great because you can carry a big fluffy bag on. But I generally, luckily because I can refluff them, I'll put them in my suitcase, which is what I did this trip.
Right.
But I'll pre-tease and pre-style them to some degree and then do the finishing touches. But Bunny's technique of stacking 5 wigs together, there's almost no teasing involved. It's enormous without
having to do anything.
Just
that's
pin
why
them
her
together.
Wig kind of feels like it has a lot of gravity, which this feels very light.
Yeah, this is completely full of air, and hers are a little more
this is not
dense.
Pinned onto my head whatsoever, and I can literally do this.
Do a handstand.
Comfort.
Well, right there, I got you a little bit, didn't I, on the side? But
it's not going anywhere, and it's just because it's
and
been styled
a,
so
there's
well.
Even a thing in the back of this wig. Go ahead and face that way.
Where?
You can just feel it. Where you can make it tighter right here. You can.
Oh,
pin
I can
that.
Pin it. Yeah, the elastic.
Yeah.
The back. But I like
in
I
the
like
kitchen.
I like it when the wig is like you know kind of like a hat. You don't have to worry so much. And if you take it off, can I just take it off?
Yeah.
Where do I?
I generally do it from the front because you
okay.
don't want to manhandle the teasing because you
okay.
compress it again.
So if I'm going to put it on myself, I don't want to. You're like, don't break the wig. I just do this.
Oh
right?
my god!
Did I just ruin it?
You. I think you would probably need someone to help you.
Okay.
This is what I would suggest: that your boyfriend come at you like this, and you hook around the side, and you place the bang. Don't lean into it.
Okay.
Back up a little more. Yeah, right there. Boom.
Boom.
And then you got
that
your
that just slid right on.
And that is how you do a Lady Bunny Tura Santana do for any drag queen around the world. Woo! Thank you so much.
Wig stacking.
Thank you,
Perfidia. My pleasure.
Bye. And now, let's dance! Woo! Thank you.
See, then when you get sick of this stuff, you could go back in and you could do this. Like, this was my first vision. I'm gonna do it, damn it.
Yeah, do it.
That's part of the, I think, the fun wig stock thing is, like...
Easy!
The silliness of 60s hairstyling was so much fun. I mean, look at how great does that look. I just saw those on the rack, and I thought, those are just waiting for some love.
I'll hand them to you.
There we go.
Doctor.
I mean, just this little bit of color is nice.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't it? And it will still match blue.
Maybe you'll win the pageant next year.
Might be the pageant winner.
It adds a very trashy element when things are pinned to teased hair. I like it.
I'm like, thank you so much, darling. I'm ready to win the pageant this year. Ooh!
And again, that was like, you know how long it took. If I'm going to go nuts, I'll like tease and tease for hours.
So Monica Beverly Hills and Jade are in L.A.